So you're thinking about funeral arrangements, and you don't know quite what to do. Well, the people at Eternal Reefs have the answer.
It really appeals to people because it's a way for there to create a permanent living memorial that will give back to the environment.
They are called reef balls. Within each one are the ashes of a loved one. It's a way to have a lasting memorial and help the environment.
Founder of Eternal Reefs, Don Brawley, father-in-law got sick and asked that he be included in one of the reefs. He just felt as though he'd much rather have the rhythm of the sea around him and all that life and action than being in a field with a bunch of all dead people. And so that was really the idea of starting to create the memorial reefs themselves, was to include people's cremated remains.
There we are.
Came out beautiful.
Today, families came to see their loved one's reef ball and pay their respects.
Do you think your husband would like this?
He would love this. This is exactly what he would do, would have done had we known. We would have had it all arranged beforehand.
He's been to on expeditions to the Titanic, to the Hood and the Bismarck, to the Liberty Bell. He would appreciate all of this. He was very young to die, and so I know that he would like this. Just no question about it.
Many did tracings of the plaques on their loved one's reef and said their goodbyes. It was all very touching.
See how the letters appear?
I'm going to use that one. Good coloring.
It was his wish. And that's what's great about it, because that's what he wanted when he passed. So
I know he'd love it. So being in the water, just where he'd want to be.
Around noon, a military honor guard performed a flag ceremony for three of those who are being laid to rest. Tomorrow, a boat will carry the eight reef balls to their final resting place in the Chesapeake Bay. These are the first Eternal Reefs to be placed in the bay. Rob Roblin, WBAL-TV, 11 News.